Welcome to the eClinicalWorks podcast. I'm Adam Salati. Today's episode is part of our special series focusing on physician burnout. Physician burnout is one of the major issues that we're addressing here in the industry today. And eClinicalWorks is always trying to improve the physician experience and reduce the burden of the physician's documentation so that we can try to combat that physician burnout. Here to speak with me about that today is Rory Glowik from eClinicalWorks. Rory, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you, Adam.
And we're going to be discussing how eClinicalWorks Scribe is one of those tools that ECW has to help fight that physician burnout. Now, Rory, you are part of our enterprise strategy team here at eClinicalWorks. So tell us a little bit about what your focus is and why you know so much about Scribe.
Sure. Thank you, Adam. Well, on the enterprise strategy team here at eClinicalWorks, we work with clients of all sizes. And I've been working over the past 4 or 5 years with Scribe in particular for dictation. Now, we've seen where documentation has come from a paper form into dictation and to the EHR. But now we see providers wanting to shift towards dictation again. And so I think that's why we want to kind of focus on eClinicalWorks Scribe today to help offer a solution for this physician burnout that you referenced.
So before we get to some of those more technical details, let's talk a little bit about the context. You know, the study recently came out from Stanford Medicine focusing on EHR experience and what providers would like to see in terms of improvements there. What are some of those things that we learned from that study? Where are these areas of burnout most being affected, and what do we know about
absolutely
that situation?
No, very good. So the Stanford study on physician burnout was entirely geared towards EHRs, and it focused on, in the average, let's say, 31 minute appointment with a patient, that a provider spending over 50% of their time, whether in the room or out of the room, documenting in their EHR. So we need to find a faster method for these providers to document their visits. A couple of the other, I'd say, issues that they've run into is whether it's, you know, too many clicks, less FaceTime with their patients, and they find that they're just typing, looking down at their laptops. And also, this all plays into a good work-life balance. So that is the problem. Now, how do we offer a solution?
Right. Definitely, if we're focusing a lot of our time on that EHR interaction, while it's important to be able to get that information in there in a reportable way that allows us to get the value out of recording that information, a lot of those things suffer, right? I mean, we hear stories about physicians staying late at the office, trying to close those notes before the end of the day, before they get home, and there's maybe not enough time for some of those other things that are so important.
Sure.
So, Rory, eClinicalWorks Scribe, right? Mm-hmm. This is something that helps to speed up the documentation of the provider's note, and like you said, the main focus is to be able to allow providers to dictate to the Scribe tool and allow that to translate into their note. Now, this is, you know, something that I think may be counter to some of the trends that we've seen up until now, because I know focusing on EHR adoption, dictation was something we were encouraging providers to get away from. You
Correct.
Know, that spoken data, you know, that was just transcribed into the note, not structured, right? So what is this evolution here? How is this, how are we coming around full circle to where we started almost?
Absolutely. So I think what you referenced to is we find ourselves as an EHR company, but for physicians, they find themselves in a world of, I need to document my visit, but I also need to make it reportable. And you definitely referenced how we tried to steer folks away from just the free dictaphone dictation with a transcriptionist. So the way eClinicalWorks Scribe works is that a provider can use basically speech-to-text recognition. They can speak into whether it's their laptop, whether it's their iPad, or even their smartphone to capture that information. This could be everywhere from the HPI through their review of systems, their examination, selecting a diagnosis, placing orders, specifying billing codes, and even locking the note all in a single dictation flow inside of eClinicalWorks. We are seeing that providers need to basically expedite their patient visits. Now, not just only get the documentation into eClinicalWorks or the electronic health record, but also to place some of that in a nice formatted structure inside of their SOAP note. In order to do that, we use the speech-to-text, basically, solutions.
So, Rory, why don't you tell us a little bit more about what Scribe is exactly and what it's supposed to do for our physicians?
So eClinicalWorks Scribe helps take speech-to-text solution when a provider dictates and helps structure it into the progress note. By doing so, a provider can have a nice formatted narrative of their patient's visit, and they can capture that data very quickly, all the way from the HPI through the billing codes.
So we're taking speech to text and we're translating that into the documentation that the provider needs to worry about. Mm-hmm. But if I understand you correctly, we're really encouraging more dictation, which is something that, you know, I know with the EHR adoption, we were trying to really move some providers away from that because it wasn't reportable. It was, you know, we needed to make sure we can get that information out. Why are we coming full circle again to dictation?
No, it definitely seems cyclical, going from dictation to an EHR, back to dictation within an EHR. So I think some of the core reasons why we did this is that we saw that challenge of increased patient time spent with patients just for the sake of EHR documentation. So with that challenge alone, a dictation, if I was an orthopedic provider or physician, I could dictate my note in under 90 seconds and get in and out of that room. So I say speed is for one. The second is that Scribe does help structure some of that data. So when we do talk about reporting, you can actually help structure it into the appropriate ROS and examination sections in your SOAP note. So we see the need to come back to this because there are, like we referred to before, actual case studies about how providers are interacting with EHRs. And I think dictation within eClinicalWorks Scribe could really be a solution.
So besides helping to format this information in the mm-hmm. progress note, you know, we know there's a lot of other structured pieces of information that we need to get into that note, diagnoses, you know, medications, things like that. What else is Scribe able to do? How can it help us to also resolve those issues?
So a few different examples would be the ability to actually select the diagnosis code by using what's known as a Scribe command. So I can say chest pain, and I use the command of show list. It will actually pull open a full list of the ICD-10 codes correlating to that diagnosis. I can then select the appropriate diagnosis and move on to the treatment section. I can place orders. I can even enter treatment notes and move all the way down to the billing codes. Add E&M code 99213 or 214. So those specific commands are actually built intrinsically within Scribe. And they can be used in conjunction with any of the macros or commands from your speech-to-text vendors, and there are many that we work with today.
Now, when you say they're intrinsic, does that mean this works out of the box, or are there some configurations that I have to do?
This actually works out of the box. The only configuration has to do with training. So it's having your resources understand what those commands are, how to use them through their dictations, and at first, there will be a learning curve. But as myself, I've been using it for about 4 years, 4.5 years at this point, I can very seamlessly transcribe a note from start to finish and even lock and send that progress note back to the PCP all with eCW Scribe.
Well, especially if it's able to help us select things like diagnosis codes and order labs and mm-hmm. even pick those billing codes, I think it can really save a lot of time. I mean, that's where, you know, you don't want to be paging through those lists and trying to find the right specific code. Correct. It can really help you out there. So Rory, what are some of the outcomes that you've seen at practices that have adopted Scribe?
So some of the outcomes that I've seen have actually had to do with clinical efficiency. So with that being said, basically saving time per patient with documentation. So a provider, and there are many different ways you can do this. You could use eClinicalWorks Scribe inside of the room with the patient dictating in front of them. You could also step out of the room, dictate back at your desk or your workstation, and move seamlessly from room to room. So you're seeing reduced patient times when it comes to the provider piece. You're also seeing the ability for a provider to get the orders in faster so that the nursing or MA or clinical staff can go and basically collect those specimens or move forward with that patient's visit. All of this results in greater time throughout the day. And with that additional time, a provider can either see more patients or they can go and they can expand, let's say, their practice within their organization.
Right, or maybe even spend more time with some of those existing patients. Now, another thing that I know is that, you know, we just came out with a case study on Scribe mm-hmm. with one of our clients, GastroHealth,
yes.
who's using this. And one of the points that I picked up from that was that there are some doctors who actually have lives outside of work.
Right.
And this is, you know,
shocking.
Shocking, as I know. And one doctor in particular said that he was actually able to make sure that he gets that time in for some of those outside activities. I think he has some hobbies and things like that that he
yes.
can dedicate time to now that he's not staying late and documenting notes all night.
Absolutely.
So it does sound like there's really a huge impact here. Where can clients go if they would like to learn more about how to use Scribe? How do they get
Absolutely.
In touch with someone like you?
Perfect. So I'd say the first level is always to go to the support portal for the eClinicalWorks. We have extensive documentation. We have videos showing Scribe and also tips and tricks inside of there. We also have ECW University that can show a provider or even another clinical staff member how to navigate utilizing Scribe. But even if we don't want to go further, we can contact eClinicalWorks through your support account manager, and we can actually connect with you and speak to your providers and show them the ins and outs of Scribe.
Absolutely. And MyDaddyClinicalWorks is also where our clients can see our other podcast episodes. You can
Excellent.
Also check those out on YouTube, iTunes, and of course we mentioned MyDaddyClinicalWorks.com. As Rory said, speak with your strategic account manager if you have any questions about any of the things that we've discussed today.
You got it.
And we'll see you on the next eClinicalWorks podcast. Thank you for watching.